Welcome back to the Sonicview XP Learning Center. The Sonicview XP series comes with a built-in 32-channel multi-track recorder. When using the recorder function, all of your tracks will be saved directly to an SD card inserted into the IF MTR32 slot on the back of the unit. We can use SD cards from 64 gigs all the way up to 512 gigs. To access the multi-track recorder, we'll go to the menu, then recorder player, and then we can see multi-track recorder here. So we can route up to 32 channels to our SD card. At the top middle of the screen right here, we can select our routing options. So this says auto routing here. If we click that, we'll be brought with three different options on the bottom here. So if we go with the direct output, we can assign either channels 1 through 32 or channel modules 9 through 40 to the 32 channels. So we'll click here on yes, connect the direct output. So we've done that. Now you can see here auto routing is set to direct out. So if we go over here and select channel 9 to pull up and we look at the overview tab, we can see direct out on. So that's what we did. We selected auto routing with direct out. And now, no matter what channel we go to, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, we can see all of these have the direct out. So that's the send point that goes to our multi-track recorder. So let's go back to our auto routing feature. So by selecting to connect the send return point, we are going to send signal from the send return point in our channel signal flow. So which we can see the send return point right here on channel 16 in the overview tab. So let me connect this, and then you should see this flip from our direct out option, which we're currently on, to the send return option. And there we go. Auto routing to send return. We select our different tracks, and there we go. Slot 1, track 12, slot 1, track 12, and then as we go down, we can see the numbers change. So there's another option you may have noticed on here. Let's go back. So now, right here, if we select this option, which reads, no, connect by myself, we'll hit this. And if you noticed, there was no change here at all. That's because it's no, I will connect it myself. So we're not seeing any changes to the channels or the send points. This is something that we'll need to go in manually on a channel by channel basis and set up and make the appropriate changes that we desire from each channel. So if we'll click up here at the top of the screen, you'll see this is in live recording mode at the moment. If we click up here, we have three basic mode selects. We have live recording mode, virtual sound check mode, and overdub mode. First, let's discuss the live recording mode. So let's select this, and then auto routing again. Yes, connect the direct out, channel 1 through 32, because that's what I want to do for this particular setup. So live recording mode allows us to track up to 32 channels to our SD card. This is where we record groups of files at the same time, or as we call it at Tascam, takes. Also, multiple takes can be played back at the same time. So in short, this is the mode we'd use to record a whole group live, or even just our drum takes, for example. So to get everything going, we'll start by selecting any group of 8 channels here from this screen. So I'll start by selecting 1 through 8. From this screen, we can select to record arm any of these channels, or we can record arm the whole group. So for example, if I only wanted to record channels 1, 4, 5, and 8, I would do that. We can hit all off to clear that selection. Or if I want to record all 8 of these channels at the same time, I can just click all on. And now we see that they're all highlighted in pink. And now we're ready to record those. From here, we can also input monitor any or all of these channels. So it's the same thing as we were just seeing. We can click on input 1, input 5, input 6, and now we're only input monitoring those. Or if we click all on, now these are all on. So now we are record ready, and input monitoring all 8 of these channels. So if we want to record, let's say, all 32, you know, blocks here, we just repeat this step. So then we next 8 channels, all on, because we selected the all on. Same thing here, same thing here. Okay, however, if we would like to only record, say, these first 8 channels, so say we're recording drums somewhere along the way, and we have the 8 channels, we're going to go ahead and select all of these, and the same thing with all the input monitoring. Now, when we go across, we'll see that only our first 8 channels. So again, if you want to record every channel input monitored, those are your options, or you have the ability to mix and match with whatever you desire. So we're only going to record this first block of 8, for example. So now, in order to start recording, we'll have to hit the record button here, and then next we'll follow that by pressing the play button. And as you can see, now we've got our meter going here, and we can see that our recording is taking process, how long we've recorded on the card, plus how much time left is on the card. So in order to stop your recording, just the same as anything else you've ever used, hit the stop button, and that will cut that. So at the left of the screen, some additional functions here is we have a loop. So we can set our endpoint for the loop, set our out point for the loop. And if we've, you know, messed up or want to change it, we can hit the clear button and also clear that. This button here currently says off because the looping is off. If we click this, we get some different options of what type of looping we'll be doing. And that can, that will all go there with our playback as well. Next to that, we have our mark options. So we can set our marks in the song as we're going, or in the production as we're going. We can click list, and if we have marks here, we can scroll through it either by using our finger or the stylus, or we can use the dial here. And then after that, we can use these arrows to skip from, you know, forward or backward between our marks. Maybe we set those in there because we want to go back and do some editing there, or we need to punch in and out and do an overdub there a little bit later on. So this button here, this is our auto record function. So pressing this is going to take us to the MTR menu, the multi-track recorder menu. So here on the right-hand side of the screen, we can see our auto record. We'll need to select this to turn that on. There are some additional parameters here to go by. So for example, start level. So we can take this encoder, and we can move it around here. And as you see, we've got our decibel level is changing. So we can make this, say we'll start, once the level coming into it hits negative 36 dB, the recording is gonna start. End level, we'll put it down a little further. So now once our level hits negative 54 dB, the recording will stop. And then end time here, you can basically look at this as a little bit of post-roll so that after the recording has stopped, you're gonna get this much, you know, you're gonna get 5 seconds here or whatever you want, 1 second, however, up to 10 even. You can get that silence inserted at the end of the take. And now for end mode here, we've got 2 different options. So we've got a parameter set here. So start level, negative 36 dB, at ends, the recording is going to end at negative 54 dB. And with take split, this means that it's going to actually create new takes and split the recording. If we were to select continue, that's basically looking at once these parameters are hit and the end level happens, it's going to pause the recording. And then next time that comes up, the level comes up to over negative 36 dB, it's going to start again. So from there, we're basically going to have to manually stop the recording because it will just pause on continue and be ready to go. It is worth noting that over here on the other side of this, we can make adjustments to our sample rate and our bit depth as well. So 48K, 96K, or 24-bit or 32-bit. Now we'll go back to our main screen here. Next, we're going to take a look at a different setting. So again, go to the mode select, and we're going to look at overdub mode, punch in and out. So let's click on this. So notice here, very first thing, connect the send return. So in this mode, we're only going to be able to operate from the send and return, which we talked about before, which was over here. So we'll click yes, connect the send return. And then here we are. Now we are in overdub mode. So this is where we're going to do all of our punching in and out. So, you know, any sort of takes that we've already recorded, we can play back and then actually hit record and jump in. So my band is recording and I flubbed my guitar solo. So I'm going to come in here on this because I was on 22 and I'm going to click there. And now we're all ready to start recording from that channel. I'll hit record and play, and then we'll go through and I'll be able to take my take again. Next mode we're going to talk about is the virtual sound check mode. So I'll click here, mode select again. Now I'll select virtual sound check mode. So here we go again, auto routing. Channel module 1 to 32, or again, 9 to 40. So we'll select that. Connect the direct output, yes. So the only option for virtual sound check mode is the direct out, which again, we talked about at the beginning with the auto routing function, which on channel 9 here on the second screen, we can see this is where it's being sent to our multi-track recorder. So virtual sound check mode temporarily reconfigures the routing of the multi-track recorder. In order to enable this, we're going to click on this sound check function right here. So now as you can see, we are going to be changing our routing. So instead of the insert point coming back, so we're sending it and going to the multi-track recorder, we're actually sending from the multi-track recorder over there. So we'll click yes. And now that's the temporary change in routing that we were talking about. So this is a great option for being able to set up a gig and get everything as close to set for the final performance as possible without actually having the performers on stage for the entire sound check. So if we have a recording from a gig that we have on our multi-track recorder here on the SD card, we can pop into sound check mode, we can hit play, and we can route that through all of our channels, and we can dial everything in with our compression, our EQ, gates, everything else. And that gives us a really great jumping off point for when the performers actually get themselves on stage and are nearly ready to start the performance. Our next video in this series is going to cover external control options for the Sonicview series. So be sure to click the link on the screen to continue on with your learning experience.